We are now joined by Mark Harston of Porsche North America and Porsche Motorsport. And Mark, good to have you on once again. Been a little while since we've seen you, but certainly exciting to get to speak with one of the foremost voices so far as Porsche Motorsport North America is concerned.
Yeah. Hi, James. No, yeah, it has been a little while. You guys have had a lot going on, and you know, the stuff that you guys were doing around the sim racing this last season has been absolutely incredible. It gets better and better every time I see it come up. So, you know, us, you know, supporting the club, we're also huge supporters of sim racing, and we love what you guys are doing.
How exciting has it been from NA's perspective to see what's taken place over the past year, where I think at the beginning of the pandemic, everything just exploded. We went from two races to four on weeknights, and then all of a sudden you end up with almost three series if you count the Zone Group Challenge that was run at the beginning of the year. So how exciting is it to see the expansion of PCA sim racing from NA's perspective?
Well, it's great because it keeps people engaged. It keeps them interested in racing and motorsport, and really kind of engaged with the brand as well. Because these guys get to have one of the most realistic experiences on track when they officially couldn't be on track last year because of the pandemic. So to see the engagement, to see the increase in numbers of people that have joined, was really something spectacular. And you know, from not only NA's perspective, but also PAG's perspective in Germany, you know, they actually had a few different countries that were interested in kind of joining this group, and a lot of them wanted to race against North America, which made it kind of cool because they were reaching out going, hey, we know you guys have a great group of guys over there, great group of cars. The competition is insane, and we want to join. So what do you think? So, you know, I think working with PCA, they're open to doing this. They've already done a race last season with Great Britain, which worked out awesome. And now we have countries, you know, different countries from around the world. I think Australia and Asia had reached out wanting to do some things. So it was really exciting to see that. And as a company, we couldn't ask for anything better. It was a great idea.
And you're talking about the International Sim Racing Challenge that took place last year, which was buckets of fun and certainly something I think we'd all like to see return in the future. And now for this year, there's also been an Enduro series that's added that we're running this evening. And now we have a charitable aspect with PCA Sim Racing finally really coming on board, especially tonight with everything that Operation Motorsport has been able to do, and especially the links within the Carolina region of the PCA and their home base. How satisfying is it to see PCA bring their charity arm, which we know has been traditionally pretty strong in real life, to sim racing too?
Yeah, you know, there's a lot of great causes out there, and the PCA has always stepped up to help support those causes. You know, some are very close to their heart, and they really take good care of the charities that they link up with. But I think it's doubly exciting for us because, you know, you're taking not only a new program, but also, you know, finding a way to tie it into something real life, which are these charities that this race will support tonight. So from our perspective, yeah, we couldn't ask for anything better. And this is why Porsche Cars North America and Porsche Worldwide support the clubs, is because they're the ones that go out on behalf of us as a brand and actually get the work done. And yeah, it's exciting to see. So we're glad it's happening.
There's a lot of expansion that's taking place on the sim side of things, and in particular with iRacing. We've seen the Porsche Taycan Esports Super Cup return in the spring. They had a successful season that just wrapped up a month ago, and we're also getting a brand new car. The 911 GT3 is going to arrive in the June build. So I look at all that. I think it's a statement of intent, and I imagine you probably know a little bit more from the NAAG side of things that, you know, this isn't necessarily just, you know, a piece of Porsche's involvement in motorsport. I really feel like this is becoming a cornerstone to the entire approach with Porsche, where it's not just about, you know, getting people to roll around on their computers. I think Porsche is beginning to see this as a legitimate training tool and a legitimate gateway into motorsport in general.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, not everybody is going to have access to the real world car right out of the gate, and that's okay. But this is actually a pretty good substitute for, how does the car perform? How does it drive? You get good, you know, a good dynamics and a good feel for those dynamics through these race sims. So for us, it's about as close as we can get to actually putting somebody in a seat behind the wheel and let them take it out for a spin. So, you know, for us to introduce new cars this way is really incredible. And I don't know if even 5 years ago we would have thought this was possible, but, you know, with the advancements and you know, the gear that goes around sim racing, the advancements in you know, platforms, this really allows us to kind of introduce new cars, you know, to the world before they can actually get their hands on them.
New cars coming into the virtual world and also the real world as well. I know a project that you've been very involved with is the, I think it, many people would say at long last, edition of the Carrera Cup to the United States. It finally arrives on these shores in 2021 and with a brand new cup car to boot. How excited has that been for you?
Yeah, that's, you know, that's really cool because in Europe, we've had the Carrera Cup going for quite a while. It's very popular over there. The European teams have it really dialed in. And for us, we want to bring that same look and feel over here. And as, you know, as a one make series, if you are a Porsche-phile and you want to come see the best on the track, this is what you need to come for. And, you know, we're pretty excited that it's going to be in combination with some other races with, I believe with IMSA as well. So for us, you know, I think, if you're a fan of the brand and the mark, this is going to be a great race for you to come out because we'll have some great drivers actually coming through these programs. Some have come over from Europe. Some have been trained here in North America. So I think you're going to get a wide variety of different driving styles, but you're also going to see, you know, the newest, latest, greatest equipment on the track as well.
How excited should sim racers be when that 911 GT3 Cup car arrives at the beginning of June? And how much fun is that going to be to drive, you think, for the iRacing community?
Well, if it's anything like the real car, they should be very excited. And like I said, this is going to really tie them into, you know, what the road going version would actually feel like. So, you know, if there are racers out there that are, let's say they're, you know, young kids getting into iRacing, maybe wanting to get into an actual vehicle in the future. It's kind of strengthening that tie between sim racing and real life road racing that I think is what makes this so unique. And you know, for a lot of people, they may never get to actually drive that particular car, but no matter who you are, no matter where you live, you'll be able to drive it. And that's something that excites us as a company.
And I think back to the earlier point that we made about Porsche making sim racing a cornerstone of its philosophy and approach, not only here in the United States, but around the world. I sit and I think through the list of cars that are available in the sim, and I think it may just be the GT2 now, with the arrival of the GT3, that's the only thing that's missing. And to my knowledge, I think that makes Porsche one of, if not the only manufacturer to have just about its entire road racing lineup top to bottom represented, which I think underscores the point, but also is significant to everybody at NANA G2.
Yeah, well, I think it shows the commitment, you know, from Porsche as a worldwide company to say, hey, look, this is something that we believe in very strongly, and we want to get people tied into it, tied into the brand, tied into the driving dynamics of the vehicles. And so, you know, we don't want to just focus on one car per se. We want to say, hey, look, no matter what your driving style, if you like the older stuff, you like the newer stuff, like we've got it here for you. And, you know, and for us, it's very important. And I think a lot of people, they probably need to take steps, to be quite honest with you. So, you know, if you were to get into an RSR from back in the day, it's going to be tough if that's your first car right out of the gate. So you need to kind of dial it back a little bit. You need to learn on some of the cars that have been around the block a little while and maybe are a little bit easier to drive and to learn on when you first start out in sim racing.
You head from the Cayman GT4 to the GT3 to the Cup cars, then the RSR, which are all fun to drive. They're different in their own ways, though. It's very cool. So I guess all I can say is any help you can offer in getting the new Cup car, the GT2 on this sim, would be greatly appreciated from all of us in the sim racing community.
I'll make a couple phone calls. How about that?
I like that thought. Mark, thank you so much for taking some time this evening to chat with us. Best of luck to you and everybody at Porsche Motorsport NA and all that you all are looking forward to working with, especially with your client programs and into this season. We look forward to seeing you in the not too distant future.
All right, James, thank you. And, you know, good luck to everybody in the race this evening. And, you know, we want to once again thank the community for helping a worthwhile charity out with this thing. And yeah, we love it. So thank you very much.